That was kind of interesting from Google is I got an email or something just a few days ago saying, hey, there's this thing called Google Workshop Lab, Google Workspace Labs, and you can sign up and, you know, maybe we'll give you access. And so I signed up for it, workspace.google.com/sign-up. So I signed up for Google Workspace Labs and I got access immediately to my, you know, surprise and delight. Mm-hmm. So I signed up for Gemini in Workspace, which includes, you know, all the usual players, Gmail, Drive, Doc, Sheets, Meet. And so now when I go into any of those apps in the web, I don't think I see these features if I log into the, if I log into these services on the web in a browser, I see, you know, all kinds of pop-ups saying, hey, you can do this and that and other thing. But if I log into the, not log in, but if I use a mobile app on, say, a Pixel tablet, you know, mm-hmm. or an iPad, I don't think I see these features. But in any case, so I signed up for that and I started, I'll have links to getting started for people interested. I should also know there's a new thing called Google Vids, V-I-D-S. And I thought it was going to be a separate service to create videos, you know, kind of like how we can create still images. But really, mm-hmm. It's a way to create presentation videos. So it creates a template for you. And you say, like, I want to create a template of, or I want a template for creating a video presentation of, you know, some project, and it'll help you build that. And it's, the interesting thing is it's not separate from Sheets and it's part of Google Docs. So It's actually built into a feature in Google Docs. In fact, I think I could make a presentation. Oh, I should try that. I should try to make a presentation out of our show notes. Maybe I'll try that after the podcast. So the other thing I wanted to mention related to that is, so my background, and for though John took a screenshot of me for it, because Google Meet will not let me look at myself on the screen, except in a thumbnail. The background behind me today is not the usual. The usual one is a beach near my home. But today this was created inside of Google Meet using the, you know, the Gemini workspace feature that I'm testing. And the prompt for it was, I wrote it down, futuristic looking office room. And it created four thumbnails and I selected this one because I thought it looked kind of neat. And so that is generated by this Google Workspace or Google Gemini Workspace feature. So I thought that was pretty cool. That was pretty neat. There's a lot of features, but a lot of them don't work the way I thought. Like, for example, one of the things you can do is in Google Drive, you can ask it to do things like summarize, you know, files or the contents mm-hmm. of files. So I asked it to summarize all of the files that begin with MobileViews podcasts in the file name. Because all our
show notes. Told you that you didn't need all of them.
Yeah, basically it said, well, here are five. we have hundreds of notes in that John and I and some of our other
It might seem friends. Like we only made five, but we actually do have topics and things that we talk about.
So it was
very interesting looking at what it came up with. And yeah. Apparently we talk about certain things a lot, like my 10 years on MobileViews. Apparently that comes up enough that it makes it into this list. The iOS 17 standby mode, I barely remember us talking about that once.
That was probably me.
Yeah. So electric scooters versus e-bikes. I think that came up once or twice. I think Google might want to look at the definition of the word all and the definition of the word, frequent. Yeah.
Well, you know, it's and that's why we test these things, right? That's why we try them out as, you know, early adopters. It's been pretty interesting. I'm not sure I'd pay for this. It's $20 a month for the current Google Workspace Gemini, you know, whatever for Google One. It's an add-on to the Google One subscription, which is only $100 a year for the 2 terabyte level. And John is holding something, but I'm not sure what. It's like a cat.
I'm holding a guinea pig.
Oh, a guinea pig.
Yeah, a sick guinea pig.
Oh, no.
He's got a respiratory infection.
Oh.
And it's made him, he's not able to smell things well. And I've been giving him antibiotics, but his house is getting cleaned right now. So he's with me.
Oh, yeah. Lift him up a little higher for the camera. Look at that. I like the coloration. Looks like my late rabbit Pepper.
Yep. So he's, you would never
ask.
You'd never really think about a guinea pig having a cold, but he's got one.
I've heard our rabbit sneeze. Or something that approximates a sneeze. She sounded like a sneeze to me. What's the guinea pig's name?
Budge.
Budge.
Yep.
Anyway, so we got...
more. I think the guinea pig was more interesting than Gemini's discussion of our show notes.
I find most animals more interesting than our show notes. We should mobile pets.
Pet mobile views.
Pet views.
Yeah, there mobile pet views. There has to be a pet that's mobile. So, you know, your giant tortoises that rarely move. We can't talk about them. They're not very mobile.
Yeah. Sea anemones, no. You know, well, I guess they kind of wave around, but you
know. Your extinct dinosaurs, we probably can't talk about them. They don't move that much.
And they make bad pets.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Well, at any rate, so it's sort of interesting. I'm not sure I would pay $20 a month for it. In fact, I would probably say no. If I were still working, and if I was not retired, I might consider the one that you pay for, the Microsoft.
Copilot, basically.
Pro, I think it's called, or something. Mm-hmm. Not to be confused with Plus, which is their PC name.
But, good old Microsoft naming.
Yeah. Anyway. Okay, so that's kind of interesting. And I might paste in some examples of some of the side notes I see. So what happens is in Google Docs, which John and I are using right now for the show notes, it Gemini shows up as a sidebar on the right. And it's given me a summary of this show note, which is actually longer than our show notes, I think. And the option to rephrase, refine, summarize again, I guess. Oh, in a specific format. Oh, that's interesting. I should try that later. Or you can ask questions of it. So it says enter a prompt here. By the way, I find it interesting that the AI gurus decided to use prompt instead of question. To indicate how you should ask a question of these AI things. It's I guess I wonder why. You know, is prompt a more precise? You are prompting them for an answer versus asking them a question. Oh yeah, because it doesn't have to be a question. You could be making a statement like make a blah blah blah. Okay, fine. I get it now. I understand. All right. And looks like the guinea pig is.
Yeah, we'll see if the guinea pig will eat since he's been having. Okay, yeah, he's definitely eating that.
Good.
So since he's been having trouble finding things, I have fuzzy pieces of hay that are his favorites.
Carrie good.
Just brought me a bunch of them. So.
Well, that's a good sign.
While we're talking, we can watch the guinea pig eat.
Yes. Guinea pigs make sounds, right? They kind of squeak.
Yeah, he can. Presumably when he's not, sick.
And not having respiratory issues.
And not happy with me squirting antibiotics into his mouth. He really doesn't like that too much,
No, I've done it to rabbits. They are not happy campers when you do that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Okay. So that was kind of my take on the world this week. It's been mostly Google-ish kind of things.